With the upcoming CSGO major only about a month out now, and just recently being 100% confirmed that it will be taking place in Sweden, so we don't have to worry about it not happening anymore, let's talk a bit on specifics of what's going to be the best options for investing for the next major and when you should buy in. As I'm sure you guys are getting kind of sick of the game going through a dry period right now, both with investing and content wise, so as always, be sure to subscribe if you do enjoy this video, help your boy get to 40k, and of course, check out my sponsor, Skinport. Skinport is a CSGO marketplace that has all the skins you want, usually from around 20 to 30% off Steam market price. I'm gonna keep pointing out breakout cases since they are really cheap. On Skinport, they'll only cost you around $1.90, while on the Steam market, they're around $2.70. And of course, there's no hidden fees or anything like that when you buy, it will always be the number on your screen. Plus, if you are looking to sell skins for real money, they only have a 12% selling fee for items under $1,000, and for items over $1,000, that drops off to a 6% selling fee. And finally, they're a completely safe and trustworthy site with a 4.9 rating on Trustpilot, so be sure to sign up with that link in the description today. Helps me out a lot and helps you save a ton of money. But for now, let's get right into the video. So first, let's talk about this major's stickers versus RMR stickers and how the situation should be completely different if you're fearful of that. RMR stickers obviously being a huge dumpster fire, all I really have to say about them in this video is that they are still decreasing in price alongside with a lot of the capsules for the time being. I still think holding them for the next year at least is the best option, but with millions of them in supply and apparently 30,000 plus of each gold sticker in supply, it's a bit of a difficult situation with them. But I think Valve have learned this time around, and since the RMR capsule wasn't a normal situation, we won't see these upcoming stickers in game on sale for nearly as long, so we don't run into another dilemma like this. This also means it's going to be way easier to make money this time around, and we're not going to see upcoming stickers just decreasing more and more after the major ends. Hopefully it's the opposite of that actually, with much less supply, and we still don't know exactly how Valve plans on integrating stickers into the game this time around either. Is there even going to be gold team stickers at all like we saw with the RMR capsules? Does that mean there's going to be gold team stickers and gold player autographs? And if so, does that mean we're going to see team capsules and player autograph capsules as two separate things? Because surely they're not just going to remove one of them and keep the other, right? That's my thought process at least, but honestly, I think it's a win-win situation. If they add gold team stickers, that's just another investment to look at, and if not, RMR gold should shoot up as they may be the only ever gold team stickers to exist, but there still is like 30,000 plus of each of them in supply. So stickers are definitely a good thing to look out for. If we look at the simple gold sticker from Berlin 2019 and any sticker from that tournament really, it seems like the best time to get in on these stickers is when the 75% sale comes around during the later part of every major tournament, and not when the capsules are at a dollar each right when the tournament comes out. So you do have to be a bit patient when the tournament drops and wait for the sale. Obviously, if the capsules are cheaper, more are being bought, more are being unboxed, which means more golds that will get sold for cheaper, but also means you can buy them at a discount. And player gold stickers are much lower in supply because there's way more players per capsule. With 40 players in each autograph capsule, that obviously means 8 teams per team sticker capsule. So I'd have to imagine with what should be at least 1/5 of the supply, autograph capsules are just going to be the better option for pure sticker investing at least. As for the actual capsules, they're always safe to buy during the sale if you look at past trends. Even with the trillions of RMR capsules in supply, they still increased when they got removed from the game, so you don't have to worry too much if you're investing in the actual capsules. As for the actual major viewer pass, since I know I'll get a lot of questions about it, the two previous ones have actually turned out to be pretty straightforward investments with very good returns if you're patient. Since so many people are focused on buying stickers, capsules, souvenir packages, all that good stuff, these things kind of get left out to dry and are definitely an option if you've got the budget for it, because there doesn't seem to be a large amount of them in supply ever. The only real downside with these would probably be selling them if you buy them in a huge bulk. There's actually more than I thought would be sold on Skimport, of course, where you can sell them for actual real money, averaging around one sold every day and a half to 2 days, which isn't really horrible for the profit margin you can make on these if you buy them during the sale. Maybe just a good way to diversify your major investment a bit, but I definitely wouldn't put all my eggs in one basket with these passes, as they definitely are a longer term investment and you are going to have to wait compared to sticker capsules and most stickers to actually make a pretty decent margin on them. But if you're ready for that and ready to wait a considerable amount of time to sell them, since they don't sell that often, they could be the move for you. Souvenir packages are one of the few exceptions that you can get away with buying at the very beginning of their release in the major, as the pass going on sale doesn't really affect them, as everyone earns them equally throughout the major by completing challenges, and the pass going on sale doesn't really do anything to change that. So unless the actual format of the viewer pass changes, which I mean, I guess it's possible, but it probably won't change it to affect the way that souvenir packages are priced throughout the major, it doesn't seem like these things are going to have too crazy of a price fluctuation throughout the major either way. So it's not something you have to worry about too much if you are interested in souvenir packages. They are definitely a long-term investment though, compared to sticker capsules where you could sell them just a few weeks after the major ends and make a decent amount of money depending on how many you bought. These things you are going to have to wait a while for. But overall, the main takeaways you have to know to make the most amount of money is that in every case besides the souvenir packages, you do have to be on your toes and ready to buy when the pass goes on sale, so have your credit cards primed and ready for that. Sticker capsules are pretty much always the safest investments to buy in bulk, easy to sell en masse, always have a spike after the sale ends, but just for major investments especially, you can make a fair bit of profit right off the bat, but the longer you wait, you are often going to see some really significant increases over the long term, like 1 to 2 years at least, which seems to be a long time, but the returns really make it worth it, as we've seen in the past. But yeah, that's just all my own opinion on investing in the major. The major is definitely the best time to get started on investing if you are a beginner, as it is pretty straightforward, but investing does always have risk, like I always have to say, and it isn't just guaranteed money, so do everything at your own risk. But looking at past market trends, just being patient is going to be the simplest and best advice I can give you once you get in on it. You don't need to worry about looking at the prices every day, so just don't stress it. But besides all that, I think that does pretty much wrap it up for this video. As always, if you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new, and feel free to check out some of my other investing content as well. And of course, check out Skimport to start saving money on CSGO skins. But for now, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.